everybody, Joey here again, and welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to build a do-it-yourself LED aquarium light that, regardless of how big your aquarium is, it will not cost you any more than $25. The benefits to these lights are simple. They are cheap and they are easy to do. They are very light, durable, and they're actually waterproof. Not to mention, they come with a full customizability. You can change the color to anything you want, and you can even change the brightness. All for $25. The best part about this is you can customize exactly how you build it, or what you use to suit your needs. In this video, I'm going to show you an idea on what I did, but the options are really limitless. So let's start off with supplies. Obviously, we need LEDs. We will come back with more details on them in a second though. You will also need a plastic rain gutter, typically used on houses. You will also need some end caps for those gutters. Now obviously, costs will vary based on location. However, I got a pair of 10-foot long plastic gutters and 4 end caps for only $12. Having a small drill and some electrical tape will also come in handy. Now on to the LEDs. I got these strips from eBay. I heard good things about them and decided to give them a shot. I got everything I needed for $37 and free shipping. So let's get started with the build. Your package of LED equipment will contain 3 packages. The first package will contain your roll of waterproof LEDs. The second package will contain your control box, the remote control, and the instructions. Now the last package will actually contain the power adapter. We'll want to first start out by testing the LEDs, by simply connecting the roll of LEDs to the controller and then to the controller to the power supply, we have completed the assembly. Now we can move on to preparing the housing for the LEDs. I cut the gutter a couple inches shorter than the length of my tanks to allow the end caps room on the ends. I used a hacksaw to cut the gutters to do this. I then drilled a few holes in one of the end caps to allow the LED strip to fit through. This way the strip does not have to exit underneath the light. I then placed the end caps on the gutter. I fed the power supply end into the hole I created in the end cap and laid the LED strip the length of the gutter. I did find the LED strip was too long and I had to cut it. Cutting it had to be done at a specific spot on the strip though. However, it still remains waterproof after doing so. Now since the LED strip actually comes with a double-sided tape already installed on the strip, all I had to do was remove the backing of the tape and lay the strip into place. With some electrical tape, I did cover the hole of the entrance on the end cap so no light would leak. I also laid a few pieces every so often on the strip itself just to reinforce it. And that was it. It was ready to be plugged in and turned on. Now the remote actually allows me to change the colors and brightness of the light, which was a huge benefit and one of the main reasons I use this light. Now obviously there are many options and ideas for this LED strip like this one. So feel free to explore what your needs are. This was simply one idea. Now I must state that this light is not going to be strong enough to grow plants or coral. It is simply used either as an accent light or a light just to be able to see your fish like I use it for. However, while I only used a strip long enough for my tank, if I were to do all of this again, I probably would have ordered a strip that was twice as long as I needed and simply run the LED strip up one end of the gutter and then back down the other side to give me twice the brightness. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys next week for another project.